All right, so we are back. If you want to call the show, hold on. Nikki graduated in 1990, I graduated in 1993. So you're only 3 years older than me, apparently. So thanks for everybody listening to the show. Those of you online, I'm going to get to you in just a second. And those of you calling in, appreciate it. So let me take this caller real quick. 678, you're on the air.
Hey, Icon, it's David. How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. You know, I'm sitting here fuming.
Okay, well, let's have it. Let's hear what you have to say.
I think a lot of white people, and like I said, I'm not a racist by any means, they don't know where the feeling comes from when you've been disenfranchised your whole life. You know, and it's not just by how you look. You know, they have the stereotypes that are out there. Like you talked on your show the other night, there's people saying they didn't date black men because of the stereotypes they have. I was like, That's insane. Unless you can be in my shoes for a week, you can't know what I'm feeling about somebody using the N-word or, you know, being racist toward me because this is the fact that I'm black. And I think whoever the call is way off base because she's not in the minority. She doesn't know. She didn't have the what's the word I'm looking for? The
perspective.
Reference.
Exactly.
That I have. And just a quick story. You know, I lived in Georgia for a long time, and I worked at a furniture store while I was there. And one of my coworkers, who was white, I was the only black staff member. And a black customer came in and didn't want her waiting on her. So they spoke to me, and I was explaining to them. I said, you know, we take turns here. That's not how we. She's like, well, I want you to help me. And so I'm like, well, I will help you, but you know, I need to clear it with, you know, I need to make sure everything's cool. So she's like, well, if you're going to do that, I'm leaving, which is fine. This is your choice. She left. And so I come back to the group that was kind of watching, see how I was reacting. And the white female says to me, she's like, I'm just tired of these niggers.
And oh, my God.
Yes. And she said about a customer, I was stunned. And she's like, you know what I mean. I looked
You're
at her. I said, yeah.
Right?
Yes. She that was the whole intent. She's like, you know what I mean. I'm like, yeah, I know exactly what you mean. You just said what you meant. And so the manager at the time was standing right there. And I said, are you going to handle this? And so he takes us both off the sales floor, and he's like, well, David, you shouldn't get mad because she felt though they was being racist to her and treating her like a honky. I'm like, what? I said, are you kidding me? And so I actually had to go to the owner because I was really good friends with the administration. And I'm like, so what's going on? They was going to move me to a different location. They thought that I was going to be able to get along with this person. I'm like, do you understand what you're doing? Yes. It turned into my problem, not hers. But then I said, well, you know what? We'll be downtown tomorrow. You know, I'm not playing with y'all. And so they actually end up firing her. And but still, I'm like, this is the whole mentality. Of course, you know, it's the South. And this was in Douglasville, Georgia. And it was one of the biggest furniture stores in the Southeast. This was the whole mentality of the company. But I'm like, you can't say that to me and expect me to be okay with it because you don't perceive me as a nigger. You know,
right.
Because I speak proper English. You know, things like that.
That's one of the things that Paula Deen said in her deposition. She was saying, well, she said something about hosting a party, and she was thinking about having all black people as servants because it would be like the old South. And then she said, an attorney asked her, well, did you call them nigger? She said, no, because they weren't. Meaning, okay, well, she uses that word to describe. She said, no, because they weren't, because they were professional and they spoke
yes,
well.
I read that.
Yeah, I'm
that's
like,
crazy.
Okay.
and I feel sorry for Paula Deen because I did like her. I've used some of her recipes, but unfortunately, sometimes you have to pay the paper, you know. And I think this is just my own personal opinion. The reason why she's doing damage control now, I think she's so casually had this sentiment, you know.
Exactly.
I think there's more than one person knows. So she's out there, you know. I don't want anybody else coming forward because I'm going to have to say I said it because there's more than one person who knows how casually I use this word and what my real intentions are.
Yeah, and even if like I said, she didn't necessarily use it in a cutting manner in her, like she just said it in a joke or something, that's still just as bad to me as saying it to someone in their face, because behind, like I was saying a minute ago, it's what's behind the scenes that tells the truth. It's what you say to your closest friends or family that matters. And you know that's what's in her heart when she says she makes jokes about, you know, nigger jokes or whatever, that she does that kind of stuff, you know that's what's in her heart. And so that doesn't
exactly
really matter to me. Yeah. So.
And I told a friend of mine on Facebook who was mad at me because I said, well, she's getting what she deserves. As unfortunately it happened, he's like, well, I just think the black person, they just want money. I said, well, think about this for a second. Take away the person who's suing her. Take away that whatever their motives are, she wants money or whatever. Take that away. The part in that equation is she still said it.
Right.
She's admitting that she did say it. So it's still there. That doesn't change anything from what she said. So I got deleted, of course. I cried for a second. No.
I just wanted to
call in because whoever the last caller was, it's kind of like you're not based in reality.
Before you go, if you don't mind, let me bring her on so she can defend herself because she tends to get mad when she can't defend herself. So let me.
Okay.
She never feels like she can have her face. So go ahead and say what you want to say.
I'm not muting
on you.
Well, also, I had wanted to tell you my friend who has a show on the Food Network. She has a show called Pioneer Woman. I know that there's a lot of things in her background. I mean, if you really look at things, and even now, and I have two biracial children, by the way, two, not just one. I have two.
What does that have to do with it?
Well, you're saying I can't understand, and
you can't.
Yes, I understand.
My mother can't. No. You can't understand any more than my mother can ever understand. My mother can understand proxy the way you understand through proxy. You have two biracial children. I'm a biracial child of my mother, who's a very, very white woman, and she is never going to understand completely what it's like to be discriminated against because of your race, because she is white. She may know
exactly
by proxy, but you don't know either. That's what I'm saying to you.
What
you
I was
really
talking about shame earlier, remember when I was talking about shame? You know, we all go through different things, and not everybody's experience is like everyone else's. I mean, there's just no way. You know, I just thought we could have a conversation. I know this is a sensitive topic for you, and I just I like what you have to say, Iconoclasset. I really do.
Well, what do you want to say about what? Do you disagree with anything else I've said or anything David said so far?
Well, I just wanted to add in about the Food Network because I don't think they're being completely fair to her.
Why not though? Why are they not being fair?
Well, because people are people. I mean, they stumble.
People are people.
That's a justification. It's not an answer.
Well, yeah, because we all have a dark side. We all do. No pun intended.
But some dark.
But
her dark side oppresses other people.
I mean, I can see where you might think that.
It's what it is.
You know, life is about differences.
But it's not about oppression.
You should have the chance to work it out You know, maybe she's not after the money, but, I mean, it disappears that way.
Well, regardless,
maybe
she's
trying to make a social statement by using Paula Deen.
But she's not using Paula Deen. Paula Deen said it. Paula Deen said it. She's not using – this was said. Paula Deen admitted.
I'm sure she has said that word many times before.
So it makes it right.
More than what she's admitted to.
So it makes it
right. You know, and she's had conversations with Ree. That's the pioneer woman. And I'm telling you, there's a lot more to her, you know. I'm not saying it makes it right. I mean, Abraham Lincoln wasn't the big liberator that everybody thinks he was cracked up to be.
No, he wasn't. You're exactly right.
But, I mean, it's just all about perspective.
So let me ask you something then real quick. So, okay, you're saying that there's more to Paula Deen than just her using the N-word and saying these things. I agree there's more to her. Everybody's multidimensional. I'm not saying that all she is a big, fat racist. I'm not saying that. All I'm saying is that what we're debating here or talking about on the show tonight is it okay or acceptable for Paula Deen to have created the kind of work environment that she did for her black employees, specifically this woman, and was it okay or acceptable for her to do that and to condone it even, and even, you know, participate occasionally in it as well? That is the question I'm asking you. Can you answer yes or no, or what do you feel about that? Are you there?
You would have to prove that she created a hostile environment, which I'm
not
100%.
Let's say you proved it. How would you feel about it, Paula Deen? Would you feel the same way?
How would I feel about it? I really don't like the woman to begin with.
Okay, so you wouldn't like her?
I don't like her recipes. I can't stand her recipes. And, ow. They just set that food out.
The question, though, is it acceptable?
You're asking me how it would change how I feel about her. I don't have the most rosy picture of her. She was on a show called Who Do You Think You Are, which is about your family
history. Yes, I know. I saw it. I saw it. Mm-hmm.
And she said a lot of statements right there. I mean, right there is a red flag. I was surprised they didn't call her on the carpet then.
I was
they
surprised.
Should have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Really talking about that at all.
What do you feel? My question, though, now is this. Do you feel, I mean, would it, do you feel what she did is acceptable is my question to you, if it's proven to be true?
You know, when someone gets to a certain age, you just can't change them.
Can you
answer my question? Can you answer the question? I am answering the question. I'm not quite finished yet. Maybe
I'm
not answering your question. You're a very quick type of person.
Say yes or no. Yes or no.
But it's not that clear cut.
Nothing has to be this difficult. Just answer yes or no. Would it be acceptable?
Oh, what? It can't be that easy.
Not?
You know, just...
Would it be acceptable or not for her if what she's done...
If it was a hostile environment, no, it would not be legally acceptable.
That was my question. What about ethically, legally, but ethically, in your opinion?
Yes, it would be ethically permissible.
Okay. Why? Wow. What about it is ethically permissible? Why is it ethically not legal? Stuff like that happens. That doesn't make it ethically permissible. Okay. I just can't get my head around your logic. I just cannot do it. I'm sorry, BTG. I gave you a chance to talk. I tried to understand you, but it doesn't make any sense logically what you're saying. You're saying legally it's not acceptable, meaning by under the law. I get that. But you're saying ethically it's acceptable because people are people, okay? So ethically, in your ethics, it's okay to call black people nigger around, or say those kind of jokes around them. It's okay to call gay people faggots or whatever. Despite your mixed-race children or whatever, you still feel it's acceptable ethically to do that. That makes no fucking sense. I'm sorry. I don't know what to say to you. I just don't know what to say to you about it. Anyway, okay, David, do you have anything else you want to say about this?
No. I will say, though, that I'm more offended by nigger than I am faggot. Faggot has really never bothered me.
Yeah, well, go ahead and talk about that. Tell me what you think about that. That was the next topic, so go ahead and tell me what you think.
Faggot has never had the negative connotations as the word nigger. There's no real oppression history behind it when you think about the word itself.
Right.
So I've just never really been offended by it. I'm like, okay, whatever. You know, I'm a faggot.
Exactly.
Cool. But with nigger, it brings up so many emotions of how I've been oppressed for being black. In my life, I've never been oppressed for being gay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why that word doesn't really hold that much weight for me. I think it's funny, and I laugh because I think it's just an ignorant mind trying to express itself when somebody calls me a faggot. That's how I look
And I think that you're right. I mean, I don't think that the N-word really carries the weight that doesn't carry the weight that the N-word does. I think that there is such a long history behind racism in this country, especially towards black people, and the use of that word and what it means and what the connotations are attached to it are, that is not, as you said, necessarily attached to calling somebody a faggot. And I agree. If somebody calls me a faggot, it means absolutely nothing to me at all. And for a very long time, up until probably like 5 years ago, you call me the N-word and it did bother me. But something happened where I began to not feel anything, I guess because I'd heard it so much, unfortunately, mm-hmm. in my life, that people call me the N-word occasionally. And it doesn't mean so much to me anymore. I think that the question I want to ask you is this. Has it lost?